is your wise and all-knowing teacher here, Mr. C, with another Tool Tuesday, and today I'm going to be talking to you about the soldering iron. I'm going to tell you what it does, how it works, and then I'm going to show you. So fasten your seatbelts, because this is going to be a somewhat slow and relatively mediocre ride, but I hope that you stick around. So this is our fancy soldering iron that is worth hundreds, if not tens of dollars. And we can use this to join things together. For the most part, we'll be joining wires together or electrical components to a circuit board like the one I'm holding. And as well as showing you how to use the soldering iron, I'll also show you how to use our wire strippers and shrink tubing, as those often go hand in hand with the soldering iron. So firstly, I want to talk about the setup of the soldering iron. You might notice that we have a switch, a dial, and what? Okay, calm down. I'm gonna tell you about why there is a sponge. So the sponge is used for cleaning off the tip of the soldering iron, as sometimes it gets covered in the solder that we are trying to apply to our joining surfaces. So an important thing to note is that we wanna keep the sponge nice and wet. So once we've got our sponge nice and wet, we want to turn our attention to the dial. And you might notice that there are a set of degrees on there. Can you imagine why we might want to use it at different temperatures? Okay, I'll tell you. So with the soldering iron, we use solder.
Wow.
And with regard to solder, there are leaded and unleaded solders. As some of you might know, lead is bad.
Uh-oh.
But the benefit of lead is that the melting point of leaded solder is lower than that of unleaded solder. So leaded solder's melting point is about 180 degrees, whereas unleaded solder's melting point is 220 degrees. And so with leaded solder, we don't have to set the soldering iron to quite as high a temperature. I believe that the solder that we have is leaded solder, and so I'm gonna set the soldering iron to about 200 degrees just to be safe. I've set the soldering iron to 200 degrees. I can hit the on switch and it will start to heat up, and you're gonna have to wait a little bit for that soldering iron to heat up, but it doesn't take too long. So just hang out. Thing that I should have mentioned is anytime heat and electronics are involved together, it's a good idea to have some of these. Because I'm using leaded solder, I want to make sure I'm doing this in a well-ventilated area, so I have my door open, I have my window blowing a nice breeze through here so that I'm not inhaling all of that sweet, sweet lead gas. Another thing that might make your job a little bit easier is instead of using the whole roll of solder, as if you take a short length of it, bend it back and forth, and it'll break off, and that should be all that you need to solder two wires together. So we have our wire strippers, and we have our wire. And what we need to do is we need to strip the end of the wire of the insulation so that it looks like this. And the way that we do that is we take our wire strippers, and we take our wire, and we find which of these teeth is best suited to cut the insulation off while not cutting out any of the wires. And we clamp it in there, and we give it a tug, and that should take the insulation right off. So once we've got two of these wires, we can braid them together and join them like so. Once we've got our wire and our solder ready, all we have to do is take our soldering iron, and instead of actually applying the solder directly to the soldering iron, what we wanna do is we wanna heat up the wire, let the wire get nice and warm there, and then when we think it's hot enough, we can try and start adding our solder.
The more solder we add, the stronger the bond will be. I want to clean the tip of the soldering iron. And you can see I've got a nice little soldered piece of wire there. So these are joined. It's a pretty strong bond.
Nice.
I'm not too worried about that. So the next step in this process would be to sheathe this wire. And so you can imagine why we wouldn't want to leave a wire like this, especially if it was live with no insulation. This could easily arc or spark, short circuit a system. So what we want to do is put a layer of insulation around the outside to protect it from potentially short circuiting. That's where the shrink wrap comes into play. So what we're going to do is cut a length of shrink wrap using our wire strippers. We can slide it over the wire, over the connection. And then what we'll do is we'll use our soldering iron again to heat the shrink wrap up. I'm gonna try and do this without burning my fingers. And you'll see that it'll start to get tight around those wires. The more we heat it up, the more it shrinks. And you can see we've got a nice little connection here between these two wires that's insulated. One thing that's important to note is that solder, once it's hardened, is quite brittle. And so this might not be the best idea if you're doing a connection where there's gonna be a whole lot of movement, a lot of stress. But as far as joining two wires together that are just gonna sit in one place, maybe behind a stereo or something, this would be a great solution for that issue. So hopefully this and that and this and that make a bit more sense now. If you have any questions, you know where to find me. I probably mispronounced or misspoke at times, and I'll probably have to cover that in class now, but hopefully I will have answers to your questions soon. Adios. Go, go, Jason.